Hello everyone, welcome to Vinod Ratinam Tutorials. In this video, we are going to learn about lambda function and it is also called as anonymous function. What it means? Let's take a scenario. We want to create a small function, but it should not be more than one line. Then in addition to that, we have to use multiple arguments without return type. If we have these types of requirement, then the best solution is lambda function. Using lambda function within a single line, we can able to create the function. We already know that a normal function can be created with the help of def keyword. Same way, for creating the lambda function, we have to use the keyword lambda. And we have set of rules. We will come back to this portion after seeing few examples so that you will get more clarity. And the syntax is very easy. The lambda keyword and the argument, colon symbol, expression. Expression is nothing but body of the function. Let's do a small comparison so that you will understand how important this function. This is a sample function using def keyword we have created, which is used to add two numbers x and y. After that, we are calling the function with the same keyword and passing two arguments 10, 25. Now let us run. The output is 35. This 10 and 25 will go into this function, then it will do addition, then it will return the value. This is how we will write the normal function. But in the lambda functions, the same program can be shortened even better. It can be done in two ways. First, let me go with a simple idea. Sum is a variable to which we are going to save the value. The lambda function has no name. You have to keep this in mind. Usually add, sum, we used to give lots of name based on functionality, right? But for lambda function, you no need to give any name. Instead, first give the keyword lambda to variable x, comma y, arguments, colon, here body of the function. The body of the function is x plus y. That's it. This is a one line of code. We have completed the program. So this is to call the lambda function. We are trying to print it, calling that sum variable, passing the two arguments. Execute. So that sum of two number is 35. Here we are using x and y as argument. The expression after this colon is the body of the lambda function. Whatever the coding logic you have to give after the colon. Then very important, the lambda function has no name. The same function can also be written like even simpler way, lambda, lambda keyword, x comma y colon, now body of the program, that is expression x plus y. So this is a function and here we have to pass the argument 10, 25. Run it, the value is 35. Either you can code like this. This is also another way we can pass both the arguments and its value in a single piece of code. Let's see one more example, that is using lambda functions along with built-in functions. First program is the program to filter out only odd items from the list. So we have the list. From this list, it should filter the odd items. So it has a return type. So I am saving it to a variable, odd list equal to list using filter. Now inside this, we have to write the function. It's a lambda function and it's going to be like an iterative model. One by one, the value will be checked. So it's a single argument. Then colon, now we have to give the expression, that is body of the function. X percentage 2 not equal to 0. Of course, when you divide a number, if it is remainder is not equal to 0, then it's a odd number. If it is equal to 0, then it becomes an even number. Comma. Now, just pass the list, contains all the values. After this, just execute. Out of this all numbers, we have 3 odd numbers, 1, 5 and 15. Within just 2 line of code, we can able to complete complicated programs also. Next program, we have the list. We have to find cube of each item in this list using lambda function. For that, it is having a return type, so cube list, a variable name, then list. I am going to use the map function, then write the function lambda argument. Now expression x star star 3, it means x power 3, 2 power 3 8, 3 power 3 27, like that. Body of the function is completed. Now what are all the inputs to pass needs to be given after this comma. So it will check one by one. Print cube list, execute. For each number, it is calculating the cube and displaying it here. This is how we have to use the lambda function. These codes available in this URL, aforeveryone.com. In that, you have to go to Python basics, then lambda or anonymous function. The same code available here. And the rules for lambda function, lambda function are small function, not more than one line. And it contains only one expression. If it is, we can't give multiple expression using lambda function, like if else, then it can have any number of arguments like a normal function, and the result of the expression is the value when the lambda is applied to an argument. Then there is no need of any return statement, like return additional keyword, no need to use it. It cannot contain comments or multiple expression. Hope you got an idea about lambda function. That's the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Happy